What is going on, everybody? We are back here at Powder Mountain. It's been about 2 years, so I'm super psyched to be back up here again. After about an hour and 30 minute drive from our hotel room, we finally made it up here. And the drive itself wasn't too bad, it was just pretty long. But the views up here were absolutely beautiful. The mountains are so cool to look at. And this range, the Wasatch Mountains, are honestly some of the most beautiful mountains in the world. So to get extended driving time through them is, honestly, I can't complain about that at all. The deal today is that we are skiing Powder Mountain. Like I said, I haven't been here in 2 years. And the last time I was here, it was awesome. The first day was like a whiteout, negative 15 degree day, absolutely freezing cold. And the second day we came here was a bluebird powder day, but I was unfortunately sick that day, so it kind of sucked. But we're back here 2 years later, ready to hit it again. So with Brighton yesterday being the best powder day I've ever had and the best day of skiing, one of the best days of skiing I've ever had, it took a toll on my legs and I was a lot more tired this morning, so we did get here quite a bit later. Despite us being here at 11 a.m. though, we're still gonna get 5 hours of skiing in, and there's barely any lift lines here, so we should still get a ton of skiing. And we pretty much just hop on one lift right there, take it up, and then go to another lift, and then it's all kind of just in one area, and it's so wide open, and it's a lot more mellow than a resort like Snowbird or Alta. With that being said, there still is some challenging terrain here, which I'm hoping that we do get to ski some of that today, but for the most part, it's pretty much going to be more cruising through the trees and stuff, and just trying to score fresh powder. This is a lot more of a quiet mountain, since lift tickets are limited, and it's much more remote. There's a lot less people here. And we did pull up at 11 a.m., but it's a lot more quiet when you arrive here. Should be a sick day. We did have to buy lift tickets for today. It's a lot more expensive than it was last time, so that's the only unfortunate thing. But whatever. We're about to hop on the lift soon. I'm going to suit up. We're at Powder Mountain. I've been wanting to come back here for so long, and it feels great being back here. Kind of like the conditions it was the last day we were here, but unfortunately, I wasn't even able to enjoy that day. But we're back up here, and today should be a sick day. And my friend John, back from the East Coast, is flying out here tonight, and I'm gonna be skiing the next 4 days together, so it's gonna be awesome.
Heavy though. Oh, very heavy. Yeah, I can't move. Yeah. Gotta wake up a little. Okay. Alright, wow, today is gonna be one of those days. Well, this was with the first run yesterday was like, and that was the best day of the season, so take my time, warm up. Good snow. Really slow day today, honestly, but no. Are you joking? I can't move my legs today. Wish I could. I'm gonna get better runs today though. This is really nice. I can't really turn though, I'm just like... Yeah. What am I doing today? I was looking for. I don't know. Nice. That's good. Damn, if I wasn't so tired today, I'd be ripping this. not really sure what to make it today, honestly. Get some good skiing in here. Ooh. Oh yeah, we can. Ooh. Oh yeah. Beautiful. Wow. Oh, it smells so good. But like, look at the way I'm skiing right now. It's just very sloppy. Ugh. As soon as I get in a rhythm, I just lose it. So yeah, it's whatever today. Honestly, I'd rather be more relaxed today too, just because of the fact that we're also going back to snowboard for like two more days, and I want to be skiing good for that. I know I'm tired of my lame ass excuses too, but kind of a real one. Yeah. 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 Woo. My legs are burning.
Alright, as you could tell, not really the sickest day of skiing I've ever had. I just felt like the skis were controlling me more than I was controlling them today. I think it's really because yesterday, and honestly this entire week, we've been skiing the best of the best conditions, and my legs are really starting to feel it. And we decided that we wouldn't ski as much today. I mean, it wasn't really a decision, it was more like we showed up here at 11:30, and then I was starving on my first run, so we went in to get food. So yeah, it was kind of hard to get a lot of skiing in today with the lack of time that we had, and with how long it took to get up that chair too. The chair is super long and really slow, and the terrain off of it is amazing, but the fact that you're not able to get up there so often, like I only got two runs in there, so I wasn't really able to cover much ground at all. I feel like there's kind of a give and take with skiing, which is that yesterday was the best powder day I've ever had, but I've used so much of my energy to get through it yesterday, and I skied around 10 hours, and then to wake up and only really get like 5 hours of sleep last night, and to come here and ski terrain like this and snow like this, I mean, it kind of makes sense that I'm not able to conduct my turns and ski as well. So it's easy to get really frustrated at yourself thinking you're not a good enough skier, but honestly, the fact that I'm taking that into account today and I realize that, I'm a lot more chill with the idea. It's just kind of the fact that I want to cover more terrain here, and I don't have to be skiing like 100% every single day. Like, I don't have to be skiing like insane, but I do obviously want to. Everybody wants to, but I think I'm more just annoyed about the fact that I wasn't able to cover more terrain today. But we've been here before. The last time I was here, I got sick, but this was definitely better than that last day. But the first day we were here was like an absolute whiteout, so that was probably the best day I've had here. But I don't think we're going to get back here this trip, but I think next year we'll be in Utah again for a while, so I'm going to try to get more than 2 days here for sure, at least 2 days, to really be able to cover most of this mountain, because there's so many zones here that I just feel like we haven't utilized, and I want to try to get like some people to ski with me here too, or me and my dad too. We also have to work out better, so we're able to ski this stuff much stronger. A lot of it is just strength too, but I mean, what can you really do when, you know, I've already trained a lot during the summer, and I'm still at the point where, you know, these amount of days of skiing will wear me out. So it's just something you kind of have to go with the flow with, because you never know how you're going to feel on a certain day. But if you keep working out and keep exercising and doing all that stuff and keep like skiing, most importantly, you're going to have better times in the future and less experiences where you feel like you're worn out. But anyways, yeah, I feel like I'm just going on and on at this point. Not really the best day of skiing I've ever had, but this is honestly one of my favorite mountains because it's so laid back. It's such a chill vibe here. So yeah, we're definitely going to come back here next year, and we're going to definitely do at least 2 days to really get a feel for the place better. And yeah, the snow conditions honestly couldn't be better today. Anyways, what we're going to do tonight is we're going to go pick up my friend John from the airport. He's going to be skiing with us for the next 4 days. Snowbird, Park City, Solitude, and Brighton, I think we're all going to do. So Yeah, it should be a great few days, but I also figured that if we don't do night skiing today and we kind of just take it easy, since we're already skiing like really reserved right now and very tired, very fatigued, I think it's best if we just rest right now and pick them up later, get some good sleep, and then ski hard tomorrow and the next few days. So yeah, I'll see you guys from where we pick off. Alright, well, that was a pretty sick ride back. We got a sunset over the mountains, the light shining through the valley. Always cool driving out of these canyons. I feel like we always get the best views in the world coming out of there. I feel like I kind of ended off on a sour note. I want to clarify that I did actually have like a great day out there today, and I was super psyched already about the day I had yesterday. But to just be out there in the mountains is amazing. I think Powder Mountain is a mountain that everybody should go to and experience if you're a skier or snowboarder. It's just easy for me to get into my head sometimes when I don't perform to the ability that I want to and I think about it too much. But I have a lot of time out here and I'm going to see all sorts of days. Amazing days, okay days, and days where I'm not skiing good at all. So I have to get used to it, I feel like. But honestly, like, I have been skiing good this past week, and today I even skied pretty all right. But it's really just the fact that I wasn't able to cover too much today, and that always bothers me when I go to mountains I love and I'm not able to cover the terrain that I'm thinking about before I go there. Nevertheless, that's a mountain that we'll be back to like every year, so it doesn't bother me too much. It's not like going to Alaska or Europe and not being able to go to those mountains for 3 or 4 years in between each other. So yeah, Powder Mountain, I mean, honestly, like, even though I didn't cover that much today and it wasn't the sickest day I've had there, it was still a great day. Skiing, you know, you can't beat it. It's skiing, surfing, all that stuff. I can't have a bad day out there. Unless I get, like, bit by a shark or something. But even then, you know, you still have a great day. So, anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Actually, no, I'm not ending here because we're going to pick up my friend John from the airport in a little while. So what we're going to do now, actually, is I'm going to work out, do all that stuff. Not going to show you, you know, there's no reason to right now, but you're going to go eat and then going to go pick up my friend John. So psyched to ski with him. I think we're skiing Snowbird 2 days, Solitude with Brighton at night, and Park City. So should be able to cover a lot of terrain, and hopefully I'm able to push myself more when I'm following him around trying to keep up, because he's a really good skier, and you've seen him in some videos already if you've been watching my channel. But yeah, that being said, let's go pick him up. It's definitely pretty weird picking up somebody from Salt Lake City Airport with New York license plates. We definitely look pretty interesting over here.
Going on, man? Hey, how's it going?
Good.
Dude, welcome to Utah.
Welcome to Utah.
It's been a good week so far.
Yeah.
What's up, John?
I got that one. I'll take that one from you.
This one?
Yeah,
yeah.
The light one.
Got you. All right. Wow. You want to leave stuff in a bag or you want to grab anything out of it?